My name is Jack Mumpower. I studied Aikido in the late 1950s at Fuchu, Japan. I was stationed at headquarters 5th Air Force at that time, and there was a cultural exchange program between the Japanese government and the American government to interest servicemen in the Japanese culture and society. Part of that program was the martial arts, and we had judo and karate and Aikido being taught at the base. For Aikido, they chose Mr. Tomiki and his style of Aikido. When I began studying in 1958, Mr. Yamada and Mr. Tomiki were coming to the base four nights a week. Mr. Yamada would be there every night, and Mr. Tomiki once or twice a week. And a few months after I began studying, Mr. Yamada went to England. And for a few weeks, Mr. Tomiki came alone, and then Mr. Ohba began coming. And from that time on until I left, Mr. Ohba came four nights a week, and Mr. Tomiki would be there once or twice a week. I studied for about 2.5 years under these men. There were no intermediate instructors, so I had personal teaching from these men hand to hand every night. The reason I'm making this tape is to pass on to my students and anyone else who's interested the method of teaching that Mr. Tomiki developed. I feel it's crucial in learning Aikido and understanding the principles. So this tape is a record of how I was taught, how the techniques were done, and it for my students and those that come after. At the beginning of each of our classes, we had some hand and foot movements we would go through for a warm-up. Before I do these movements, I want to explain a little bit about them. First of all, when you do them, you keep your knees bent, your weight on your toes, not on your heels. This is true in all of your movements of basics or whatever you're doing in Aikido, not just these foot movements. But you'll keep your knees bent, weight on your toes. Your knees act like shock absorbers, keeping your body moving smoothly. You don't want to bounce up and down when you move. Don't land on your heels. When you move, you're moving on the toes or the forward part of your foot. As I move, I don't want to do this. I was taught that this is bad. So you always move on the toes, keeping this balance. The center line of your body is your strong point. Your techniques will be done here. You'll see these hand movements use this center line. Fingertips will always come to about eye level as you make these movements. Imagine you're standing on a cross on the floor. You're over the cross position. You've got four corners, left, right, left, right. The foot movements use these lines and corners for movement to avoid attacks. Imagine the center line is your attack line, something coming at you, and you'll understand these foot movements a little better. I'm going to go through these hand and foot movements now. They go on a count of eight. I'll do them at a fairly slow pace so you can keep up with it. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. 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 I want to cover several points in training points that Mr. Tomiki taught, and I'll begin with the stance of how you face your partner or training partner in basic training. There's two facing positions, normal and reverse. The first one is normal, would be right to right or left to left. In this case, we're facing normal position. If I change positions, we're now reversed. So we call two positions, normal or reversed. All of your basic techniques are normal except 2 and 15, when you get into your 15 basic techniques. Your stance starts with a cross hand position. This would simulate your blocking point. If a hand were coming to me, I would block it here at this point. Fingertips about eye level. You start static when you're training beginners. Always start from this point of a standing position. As they learn, go through the basics and learn those movements, then you move to a dynamic point where he comes up to attack toward the chin and you make this same contact point in motion. Balance is important. You always keep your balance. I explained balance a little bit in those foot movements a few minutes in the earlier frame. You're keeping your weight on your toes, off your heels. As you move, your heels are slightly off the floor. Your center point faces opponent. His balance is the same. If you draw a line from toe to toe and cross it, you get the weak balance point. You always try to apply technique on these balance lines. Get his balance point, break his balance as he attacks, and apply technique. When we start a position, catching, and I make a move to catch, for example, in basic four or any catching position, say if I'm catching his hand, always the index finger remains open. If you watch the techniques, you'll see this finger open. For example, here, the finger is open. For another move, if I catch down, you always see this finger open. The strong catch point is with your little finger and the next finger, not with the index finger. It stays open. There's a reason for this. When you close your hand completely using the index finger, there's no leverage position. If you keep this open, it forms a triangle between the little finger and the index finger point. So when you catch someone's arm, you have leverage to apply with this catching position. So this is the reason for this catch position. That's one reason. There's another reason also. In Aikido, you'll never see Mr. Ohba or Tomiki with their fists closed unless they're hitting. The hand is always open. If someone grabs your wrist, you'll see their fingers open. Aikido power is outward, not inward. With your fists closed, your power is inward. With your hand open, your power is outward. Aikido keeps your opponent away. It forces your power out, forces the power to your opponent. With your fists closed, you're pulling inward. This brings your power in. You don't do this in Aikido. It was explained to me that this, your Aikido power is outward always. We're going to get into the basic 15 techniques and demonstrate from a demonstration point the 15 basics. The first basic technique is a counterattack against a straight-on attack. It's a normal position, which is right to right. We'll start with a static technique, which is a standing technique. Anytime a hand or a fist is coming at you, this would be your block point. When I counter this here, this and this is the same thing. This is simulating a blow, which really is putting him down. From a dynamic move, he makes the same move toward me. When you're teaching basics to beginners, you always start basics for beginners on a static so they understand the principle. Once you've got the static move, then you go to the dynamic as he moves in. His motion now changes. Once he starts moving, his balance is changing, so it changes your technique slightly as you adjust for his movement. As he comes at me, a couple of applications for this basic technique. If someone grabs your wrist here, balance, attack. or from behind. He comes up and grabs my arms from behind here. This is basic number one. It's your first counterattack technique. Basic number two is a reverse attack. That's reverse in our stance means that we're facing opposite hand and foot. Southpaw position if you're talking boxing. If his left were forward, my right would be forward. Or if my left is forward, his right. But it's a reverse, called a reverse position. The basic number two is a counterattack. If a hand were coming at me, I would block it and attack. That's the static move, or basic stance for basic training. This is, once more, one, two. From a dynamic move, his hand is coming at me. Okay. For application of using this technique, one method would be someone grabs here. Another one would be from a punch technique, if he threw a punch here. When you're doing basic techniques or any application, the basic one, two, anytime I end up in this position hitting him, it's an application of this reverse tech number two, no matter how I get there. So as you apply these basic techniques, you're applying principle. There are many hundreds of ways you can end up in this technique, hitting in this reverse position. All of them are, anytime I end up this way, it's an application of number two. So if you think that of all the basic techniques, whether it's wrist, elbow, whatever, anytime you end up in one of these positions, it's an application of that technique. The third basic technique is another counterattack technique, and it's a normal technique this time. Starting from a normal position, assuming an attack came toward me, I would break the balance on his line with the hand break, catching the arm behind the elbow, pushing him down on that balance line, then come back with an attack. As he tries to regain his balance, I'm going to come back and attack. That's the static portion from dynamic. He comes in. From an application point, if he grabbed my wrist here, or from a punch position, these are all the same basic move using that application or basic number three technique. The next four techniques are elbow techniques using elbow pressure, and they work sort of in sequence. Like number four is a push down type technique, and we'll do it first, then carry on through five to seven, and you'll see how they build as you go. But it's an elbow pressure technique. Again, always your balance is set. You're on your toes, light, ready to move. His hand attacking, I block and break his balance on this line again. Do this from a different angle. For application, we'll use a grappling technique. Also, we'll use a punch technique. Let's take a reverse punch, and he throws a punch to my face. When I counter, he gets a block up against my attack. taking that across. Okay, this is basic number five, and there's two ways that basic five works. One is a continuation of four. If on basic four, you break the balance and start to push him over. If you feel resistance on that push here, he tightens up and begins to fight that push, you go to a pull-down called a pull-down technique, bringing the balance straight down with this wrist. You pull it down, and at the same time, you back up, breaking his balance. Here, you change to the wrist and elbow, and bring him down with elbow pressure. The lock locks him down. Let's do that from a different angle one time. Same start. I break his balance and start to push. He resists. Bring him down. Catching, changing. In this lock position, my knee is pressing the back of this arm to give me leverage. Okay. This is the first part of that number four. That's resisting a pushover. Another way you can do this is if you break somebody's balance and they completely are off balance, and you bring it right on down into a pull-down position. In this case, here, you bring it straight down into your pull-down, which this hold-down is the same from here on. So both ways are proper for basic. For application, let's take first a punch position. He throws a punch, I block it and attack. Once more. He counters up on my attack. As he throws an arm up, I use this arm for the technique. Catching, pull his balance across slightly to get his balance and then bring him down the same way. Another application would be from behind. If someone grabs your arms from behind, here, coming up, up, catch this arm and pull down, and again lock the elbow. Okay. That's basic number five. Or basic number six is another resistance type of technique. Again, if you were starting basic number four, you're starting here, and you start to push over, and the person, instead of just tightening up and resisting, he pulls his elbow down stronger. Okay? Here, I shift in, locking the elbow, and take him down. The finger pressure and wrist pressure takes him down. So this is this point coming over your own wrist. Another important point here is at this point, you continue holding this forearm here. Don't shift up to the wrist. Once you do this, you've lost your elbow technique. You continue holding this very firmly. So when you come over, you've got elbow pressure. Once you slip here, you lost it. From a dynamic move, for application, suppose he grabs me and starts to pull up here, and I start to begin to pull down, pulling my arm here. Another application might be he threw a punch. I start to push over and he resists. Once slowly on that. Here, 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 here. Okay. Basic number seven is another resistance for the elbow technique, and it's resisting your push down again or take down again. You go past the push down into your pull down technique, and he resists that. So we'll start from here. The basic pull down was here, here, and pull down. You take him on down from there. Once you start the pull down here, you start trying to take him here, and he bends his elbow slightly and starts pulling away from you, trying to resist your takedown. At that point, you step up, sliding this hand up under his arm and locking. by turning on your toes, lifting the arms slightly over the head, you throw him. This is an elbow and shoulder throw. Once more. From a dynamic move, it'd be basically the same thing. He attacks. For application purposes, we'll first take a grab technique. He grabs here, attack, using basic number one application. Come up, grabbing, take down. You try to pull down and he resists again. Throw. Another one would be from a punch technique. He starts to punch, counter, here. Blocking here, you try four. He resists here. Take down, throw. This is basic seven, which is a resistance of four. You see this progression of four through seven. You're always attempting four, and based on his resistance, you apply one of the other techniques. Eight through 11 in the basics are wrist twist, as I was taught. Inside is a twist, outside is a turn. So 8 through 11, all rotate the wrist inward. 8 is, again, your basic stance. It's a normal technique. You meet your opponent or attack coming in by your normal block position. It's a block, catch. Catch the edge of the hand. You bring the attacker up on his toes with pressure, his wrist pressure upward, then down. Once he's on the floor, you lock that wrist pressure in. From a dynamic move, from a grappling technique, he comes up, grabs my wrist from behind. As I turn to take this technique, coming up, this hand rotates, sliding back and catching his wrist the same way. And from there, it's the same as your basic again. From a punch technique, go ahead and punch. And this is basic number 8 out of the 15. This is basic number 9, which is another wrist twist. And we start normal again, the basic stance. I break his balance by blocking and carrying it on his balance line again. Balance, bring the wrist down, catching the edge of the hand. As my hand and or my foot and his hand are almost moving together, just right together. I catch the edge, come up, bringing him up on his toes with wrist pressure. The next move is to take him down here, pulling down and rotating this wrist to get pressure. Once more, I'll go through it one more time. From a dynamic move, his hand is coming at me. For application purposes, we'll use two applications. One is he comes up and grabs my arms from behind, up with the arms, catch this wrist, and here I'm going to throw him instead of holding him. The last one is a punch technique. He catches here. A little bit different hold down is lock it from behind. That's basic number 9, and with two applications of it. Number 10 is a wrist twist also. Again, a normal position, starting here. It's a block, catch. Block, catch. Rotate his wrist, and then take down with a push down, using the elbow for control, but wrist pressure is the main point of pressure. The wrist technique for this is I break his balance here. The inside of my hand, this below your index finger, presses on his knuckle above his index finger and rotates it. This is a wrist twisting motion. Then you've got his wrist locked. Little finger is basically in the bend of the wrist. Thumb is around the back of his thumb. Once more on a static takedown. Here, 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 and lock. From a dynamic move, see attacks. For application, we'll take a little bit different move. This one, he reaches as if he were coming to reach or push or grab me in this area. As he comes in, I block, catching his arm, forearm, and rotate it so his wrist turns over. I reach right behind his wrist, catching it in the same grip. From there, I have the same takedown technique. For the next technique, if he grabbed my wrist here, here, once more on the wrist grab part, from the grab, my motion is to take him out and up, getting that wrist twisted. Then it's easy to grab the wrist in the basic 10 position. From there, it's just a push down again and lock. Basic 11 is the last wrist twist technique. It starts normal again. It starts almost like a pull down 5 technique. You grab the wrist, pull down, lock backwards on the wrist, and apply pressure to toward the head slightly and down, very slightly. Not too strong because the wrist is in a weak position. Once more. There's two takedown methods on this. One is the normal takedown, which you just saw. The other one is more a slight resistance to the takedown. I get started to take down here, and he's pulling slightly. As he pulls, I apply pressure against this wrist, upward into the back of the wrist, and at the same time hitting the back of the neck, throw. This is a throwing technique using that same basic. From a dynamic attack, but this time will not be the throw, just a regular takedown on a dynamic attack. Here. Okay. For an application of this move, if someone happened to grab your wrist, here, making a circle, you bring the wrist out and into the same position again. Once more, he grabs here, twist, locking his wrist, and you're ready to take down. If he resists you at this point, you can throw. And this is basic number 11. Basics 12 through 15 are your wrist turn techniques. Turning is outside. And the way Mr. Tomiki explained the principle to me this way was taking the wrist, putting it in an angle, back, so there's an angle on the wrist, the other side. So it's down like this. The wrist angle is like 90 degree angle on the wrist. Pressed down, there's no counter muscle. This is a principle. When you apply pressure here, the person's going to go down or get a broken wrist. You don't push it into the person. You turn that angle downward. pushing in, there's no pressure. So that is not correct. The angle is what makes the technique work. So the 12 through 15, apply this angle. 12 starts normal. From the attack, you would block, break balance, reach over, taking this hand, the thumb is on the back of the palm, fingers, little finger, and three fingers are inside. Break balance, catch, this hand rotates, catching the same way, and throw. Once more, from a dynamic move, he comes toward me, balance, throw. From a grappling point, he reaches and grabs my wrist. Here, here, coming back on that arm. Once more, he grabs. My first move is to break his balance. Remember the balance line. Here is balance, catch the wrist, come back on the wrist, and the same wrist pressure again. From a punching technique, I counter attack. Using number two to start with, I'm trying to counter with a punch. He resists it. I've got hold of this arm. Let's do that again. Here. As he counters me, I rotate and break his balance. Here. Here. Catching this wrist. Those are applications of this basic technique. So that's basic 12 using the wrist turn principle. And this is basic number 13. Again, it's the second wrist turn. And starting normal, this is a blocking. I begin to block and push him by the elbow, pushing against his elbow. Uke begins to resist here. As he does, I slide this hand up across the back of his hand. My thumb hooks his thumb. As he's resisting against me, I suddenly release this arm and let this hand slide up, which releases his balance, and I begin to turn, taking him down with wrist pressure. Once again, from dynamic. For application of this, we're going to use a boxer maybe, coming in at you jabbing. He's jabbing to my face. My motion would be to counter that jab and push his balance slightly. His natural reaction would, if he resists against you, is to do the same thing. Grab this wrist and apply the pressure. But once again, from the jab, he jabs and I push. Natural reaction is resistance. That sets his wrist into that position to make easy to take this technique when you release the elbow. Okay. That's number 13 out of the basics. Basic 14 is another wrist turn. This time is pulling downward on the arm, but starting with your normal basic position. I come in and catch this hand. There's two ways I can catch it, from here and here, the same time. These hands work together, here and here. For my basic catching position, I reach up and catch it. As I pull down, this hand comes around with it. So they're locked around his hand. This is a wrist technique, so the wrist pressure is what's turning him and bringing him off balance. Once more. From a dynamic move, he comes at me. And this time, you'll notice as someone's moving at you, when it becomes dynamic, you have to adjust your position and movement for him. You can't stand still. You're never still. So as he comes at me, here, same balance. Again. For an application point, if he reaches and grabs my wrist, here, catch. Or from a normal wrist catch. As he catches, I rotate, catching his wrist here. Lift this elbow and turning the wrist. Again, the takedown is straight back. Don't pull down, just slightly back and drop him. That's basic 14. Okay, this is basic number 15. And it's a reverse technique. The only two reverse techniques out of the 15 are 2 and 15. And which means we're right to left or left to right. In this case, my left position and my right position, and we're reversed. Again, a normal contact point. I block inside, catching his wrist, pulling down. As I do, this hand catches the outside. Same catch as in number 14, but from a reverse position. As I begin rotating this up, bringing his balance, I turn and throw from behind. From the opposite side, so you can see the finished part of it, I'm inside, catching, balance, the hands catching both sides, begin turn, rotate back, and throw. From a dynamic move, let's take it from this position. From a dynamic stance, he starts a movement toward me. Here, here. Once more. As he makes his move toward me, I come back, blocking and catching his wrist, catching this wrist inside with both hands. Once more. Here. That's a reverse move. Another one would be two hands catching. Reverse position. For this technique, it would be reversed. Here, here. As he moves in, I rotate this wrist. My wrist is behind his a little bit, so it's difficult to see what's happening. Once more. Here, here. Move your wrist so they can see the catch. From here, the catch is the same. Once more. He catches here. Same. So this is with two applications using number 15 out of the 15 basics.